Utah, homes of arches, canyons, and of course, Capitol Reef National Park. Today we're going to look at the park through a different perspective than we have been these past few weeks. Like most Utah parks, it began with Native Americans living in the area around 12,000 years ago, and the native Fremont people settling Capitol Reef beginning 2,000 years ago. Many European settlers passed through the area looking for places to establish Spanish missions in the 18th century, and route for the Transcontinental Railroad in the 19th. If this sounds familiar, it's because much of the Capitol Reef story is similar to the other parks we have discussed on this channel, including Black Canyon, Bryce Canyon, and Canyonlands. Like other Utah parks, Mormons settled the area in the late 1870s, creating the town of Fruta. The town was eventually deserted, and it wasn't until the 1930s when President Franklin Roosevelt declared Capitol Reef a national monument. It would take another 35 years, however, before Capitol Reef finally reached national park status in 1971, when President Nixon declared the area as so. The reason why this park is so different naturally than the other four Utah parks lies in its geology. The feature known as the Water Pocket Fold creates a 100-mile warp in the crust of the Earth. Due to shifting fault movements around 60 million years ago, one side of the fold rose 7,000 feet higher than the other. The feature gets its name from the many water pockets, which are small depressions in the rock created by water erosion scattered throughout the fold. The highest part of the fold is located at Capitol Reef, for which the park is named. This part of the fold is called Capitol Reef because of the sandstone domes that look like the Washington Capitol building and the rocky cliffs which look like a coral reef. At the northern end of the fold is Cathedral Valley, which was formed earlier than the Water Pocket Fold during the Jurassic era, insert Jurassic Park reference here. Features like the Temple of the Sun, Moon, and Stars can be found here. Two of the most interesting geological features here are Glass Mountain and the Gypsum Sinkhole. The Glass Mountain was created by groundwater flowing through the gypsum in the area, causing a pileup of the rock creating the large hill. Gypsum Sinkhole underwent the opposite process of what occurred at Glass Mountain. At the sinkhole, groundwater is dissolving the gypsum around it, creating a humongous pit 200 feet deep. While Capitol Reef is probably Utah's least known national park, it still has a lot to offer both history-wise as well as loads of geologic wonders.